Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about attenuation. It's a word that gets bounced around a lot, and a lot of my customers try to use it, and I can sense they're a little confused about it. So we're going to work on definitions, and hopefully this will clarify everything. It's not complicated, but let's walk through some of the steps. Attenuation is a reduction or loss of intensity or energy. So when we attenuate, we're losing, and I guess it's kind of hard and difficult to understand. I think I kind of understand. Maybe a lot of my clients use attenuation to mean boosting or more, but it's really a loss or a reduction in energy. What do sunglasses do to sunlight? They attenuate. So they lower the amount of sunlight that you get on your eye. So that'll help you. In acoustics, it's all about sound energy. So you've seen the term decibel. Well, there's the symbol for decibels, and that's how we measure the acoustic attenuation of sound. You always see things written plus or minus 4 dB. SPL, sound pressure level, and dB is our unit of measure. So those two always go together. So we have to realize that attenuation is a process. And in that process, there's rate and level. And I think this is the confusing part for people. So let's talk about how we work with rate and level. I got 5 and 6 kind of upside down, but that's okay. Level, and when you build a product to absorb energy, level is the frequency of resonance or how low that product will go. And then energy above that number is absorbed and energy below is not. So let's say we design a product that goes down to 40 cycles, okay? We design a product that goes down to 40 cycles, everything above 40 will be absorbed, everything below 40 will not be. So that's the level of absorption that that product produces. The rate is how much it absorbs at each frequency above that level. So attenuation is a process that has rate and level associated with it. It's frequency dependent. There's a lot of variables that go with it. So there's not any one size fits all, as always with acoustics. So in summary, we want to realize that attenuation is kind of like entropy. It's depletion of energy from a system based on what we're doing in the process of absorption. So attenuation, a good word, a good a good way to define and think about it is loss. So that's what we want to think about, not gain but loss. I think that's easier in our audio world to think about. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support, and if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. Our room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.